Shalom Israel, this is Sister Kana, and I'm in Kadesh, and we are about to go into Kadesh. Well, I'm in Edom, and we're about to go into Kadesh. I like to give the biblical names, so I have to give all glory and praise to Ahayah, Bahashim, Yeshayah, Wakwadash, Wawak. And I want to say bless you all, and you know, I'm here with the children of Israel, you know, a small remnant of the children of Israel. But we're about to go into Kadesh. We're going to visit the sites that our forefathers sojourned in and, you know, helped build, actually. So we're going to just stay posted, and you'll see our journey. We're actually going to do three days in the wilderness and, you know, in Kadesh, and I'll videotape it and keep you posted on what is actually going on. And we're real excited because, you know, this will be the first documentation of a Hebrew Israelite who understand who they are actually coming into the Holy Land Kadesh, which means holy, and, you know, visiting with our eyes open and understanding who we are and what this place means to us as a people. This is, you know, and I'm going to touch on this because it's very important. Right now, a lot of the Hebrew Israelites are going into a debate with the Egyptologists. And they're talking about our history. And the Egyptologists, or the people who believe in Kemet, are debating them on the Hebrew Israelites actually being in Egypt, and that and showing them that there's no proof that we were even there, and discrediting the Bible. But I want to see if our Hebrew Israelite brothers, because I accused the CIA have taken down our brothers, and I have accused them because they're not giving correct information. Now, this debate that's coming up will give every Hebrew Israelite the opportunity to talk about Jordan and Petra, where all the tombs of our forefathers. It's a lot of tombs there, a lot. And we know the biblical stories that millions of our people died in this area, and even the ones that the Most High destroyed. But yet, these brothers won't even bring it up. They won't bring it up. Why? Because they have been taken down by CIA. They don't even want to tell you that it was Jordan where the Holy Mountain is. It is Jordan where our forefathers sojourned for 40 years. Basically, they just went in circles from Aqaba to Petra, Kadesh, for 40 years. And they tried to, you know, I came out with the information, and they don't want to even speak about it. They want to tell you it's in Saudi Arabia. Why? Because they know you can't get to Saudi Arabia. They know that that's outside of the borders. And if you try to go there, you know, the Most High is not protecting you there. So you can be harmed. And, you know, we need to be within the borders. And Kadesh is within the borders. So I'm challenging you. When you start to see this debate, if you actually going to stay in Babylon to watch that, and if you're going to spend your money for that nonsense, because all it is they're stalling you. They're stalling you. They're asking you to spend money on Purim feast in Babylon, which is coming up. This debate, which is coming up, they're charging you money for. To give the truth. And then Passover again, they do an elaborate Passovers again. You will be ran out of money. You won't be able to flee. And this is a crucial time, because the Most High said, come out of her, my people. And they are stalling you and spending up your money and spinning your wheels with a bunch of nonsense instead of you obeying the command of coming out of Babylon. But I just wanted to show you that this is geographical proof, and archaeology proof that our forefathers dwelt, left Egypt, came over across the Red Sea, and went into Jordan and dwelt there for 40 years. The proof is all those tombs that's in Petra. And no one wants to speak about it because they don't want to let you know that Jordan is the actual place that our forefathers resided in. So, okay, I just want to put that out there as we go into the wilderness. I think it's a perfect time that we are here because it's right before the debate, and this will push the envelope for people to have to speak about these things. As a matter of fact, the brother Polite asks Gabbar, what proof do you have that there were Israelites that left Egypt? What proof? He asked them. He said, have any Israelite ever wrote a book about it? So I have written about it, and I put it on my blog, and most Israelites know about it. They know about my whole push for Kadesh being in Jordan, but yet no one wants to bring it up. They don't want to use it because they have been taken down by CIA. They can store you and do these shenanigans, but they can't give you the real information. So if you look over my shoulder right behind me, that's the mountain of Mount Hor, where our forefather Aaron has been buried, and we will be going there, and we'll videotape there, and we will be the first Israelites who know the truth, who will document this information, and hopefully that these brothers can use this information in the debate so that they can show you that where our forefathers were, and they can no longer lie about it. So anybody watching this who is a part of any of those Israelite groups, you need to be bringing up these kind of questions. If this information is not given in the debate, then you need to wonder why. Because it's here. And because of our captivity and the curse, we didn't know that Petra was the place that our forefather. But all those tombs, many tombs, millions of tombs, because our people, you want to have record of where our forefathers are, you want to have a tomb, you want to come and dig up some bodies, come to Jordan. And then as a matter of fact, we're going to do a big, now I don't want to say conference, we want to do Passover here in Jordan. Because the Most High said, come out of her, my people, the new blood red moons are lining up under our Passover. Iran is in the war, and all the prophecies have come to pass except the great earthquake. And you don't want to be in Babylon to see that prophecy come to pass. So it is time for us to come out of Babylon. We are setting up to have an area that our people can come to initially. We will hold a conference. And this invitation extends also to any Egyptologist who wants proof of our forefathers being over crossing that Red Sea. Because the Most High had taken me to where the actual Red Sea crossing is. Also to Mount Sinai. And also to these other monumental land, landscapes of where our forefathers dwelled. So again, Israel, I just want to put it out there. You should be questioning the information that you receive regarding Kadesh, regarding Mount Sinai. They have to go into this information. It's only the Most High that they got to go into this information of where our forefathers dwelled in order to prove that we was in Egypt. So in order to prove to these Egyptologists that we were in Egypt and we dwelled there, you got to be able to prove where we came, which was Jordan. Kadesh is in Jordan. And the tombs of Petra is what is proof. There ain't no real other proof. And so they trying to deceive our people by not telling us where to go. But yet, it's the Most High that I can make this video today and give you proof. So when we videotape today, you're going to see all the tombs, all the information of where our forefathers came to after they came across the Red Sea. And I'm thanking the Most High. I'm giving glory and praise to Him because they try to not acknowledge, they try not to acknowledge me that the Most High had dealt with me and sent me out because the CIA had taken our brothers down. They took them down. And they are controlling their speech. They're stopping the information, the pertinent information that we need, like where the borders are, where we supposed to be that's safe. Okay, so all of our brothers and sisters that's in Alexandria and the parts of Egypt that you ain't supposed to be in, it's now just time to start making your way within the borders of the Most High. Come, the tabernacle will be built. We will have a safe place, and the scriptures tells you, and we're going to prove it so that our Israel can come together and start preparing to be this nation as Christ get ready to deliver us. So I'm going to say all glory and praise to Ahayah Bahashim Yeshaya. We're going to videotape when we up at Mount Hor and our whole journey for the next 3 days. So Barakathah and Kwam Yasha Allah. Shalom Israel, this is Sister Kana. And the children of Israel is inside Kadesh. We are here and we're going to make our way through. You want to try to sit Sinai on the horse just to give her a little ride? And somebody sit with her.
She running away now?
She's scared. Three horses, you want?
No, just the two.
Wait till it gets closer to you. Oh, Jordan, you're going to go with your brother.
She don't want to try it? You don't want to try it?
She's scared.
Hey,
You're going to go down a little bit, George. You're going to come off and let your sister go on, okay? Okay, I'm going to share. Y'all good?
Yeah, I'm good.
Is the other one for her?
No.
No, it's okay. Come on, she's going to come off. I mean, he's going to come off and she's going to go on.
Not that fast. Jordan.
Come on, guys. Let's go.
What about for the lady? We'll bring her for her horses.
She don't want to do it.
It's for fun, you know.
No, it's enough. She said no. You gonna try it next? So how does it feel to be in Petra, in Kadesh? This is where your forefathers was. You know the story of Moses, yes? You know how they came and they wandered in the wilderness 40 years, yes? And so how does it feel like to be here, where they were, right? To the actual place. Do you feel anything about it? Like, do you like it? So say something to the camera. Say anything about the children of Israel, about Moses, about the Most High. Nothing? She's shy. They just love to haggle you and make you spend money in the... Came over here, they crossed the Red Sea, and all these tombs, of millions of tombs of our forefathers. Why are they telling you? Who carved all these rocks? After they came out of Egypt, they were master builders, master carpenters. Yes?
Yes, they were.
Who but our people? Who but our people? Where in history have a people built another country as we did all over the earth? We have built up every country.
Every, every,
every nation, basically.
Yes, every nation, every kingdom, we built it in captivity.
That's right.
And our captivity is coming to an end.
All of them.
But this, when you come to Kadesh, it is pure evidence that the children of Israel came out of Egypt, crossed over that Red Sea into Jordan.
From Egypt to Babylon.
And now,
Babylon,
we're going to show you the evidence.
Back to Israel. From Israel, we ran.
So
the Greeks were there.
So you Egyptologists, you want proof?
The Romans came and
got us. You want evidence? You want evidence?
And we ran into Africa. Then the Arabs got us and drove us across the Sahara Desert. And then come the Europeans grabbing us and taking us to the Americas.
Yes, right.
So we built every kingdom on this earth, every powerful kingdom that our children, the Hebrews, have built.
Praise the
Highest. Every last one.
That's right.
And the last one is Amrika, as they call it in Arabic, known as America or Little Babylon. Okay.
Praise the Highest.
That's the last one.
Praise the Highest. So Egyptologists or people who into Kemet, you want proof that we came across that Red Sea and dwelled? These tombs are your proof. These are the grave sites of our forefathers who wandered in the wilderness for 40 years. So if you don't want to believe the Bible, we're going to give you some proof. And these Egypt, and these Hebrews who have been infiltrated by the CIA can't tell you. But look at this right here. Same kind of structure that was in Egypt. Same kind of structure that was in Egypt. Our people built up Egypt. We were in slavery. Yes. We built that up. We were in Egypt during the time. Now, you want to argue whether we built the pyramids or not? That's up to you. But you know we were in there in slavery,
you know,
in captivity.
And
built the same structure that's in Egypt is here
in this rock. This rock in southern Jordan.
Same thing. You do the research. Okay, but these sold out Hebrew Israelites can't tell you that because they can't point you to Jordan because you're supposed to go to Saudi Arabia outside the borders. That's why.
They ain't Hebrew Israelites. They sold out Negroes, okay?
Mm-hmm. Yep. They can't tell you to come to Jordan because the CIA is controlling them.
They gave
them money.
The real Israelites will tell you where to go. They'll be honest with you and tell you to flee Babylon.
And where to go.
Yeah, where
they wouldn't put you in Africa knowing that they're going to take you down in Africa. They ain't
exactly
going to send you to Africa. They wouldn't send you.
Exactly.
Check this out. Look at these rocks. Look how far that came down. Mm-hmm. Praise the Highest.
That's at least about 800 to 1,000 feet up.
Look how beautiful this place is. You got to come see it.
Every
Israelite who know the truth need to come to this place and give homage to where your forefathers dwell. The spirit of the children of Israel is here. And you know it when you come. We're going to praise the Most High for waking us up to this truth and giving us this information. And I praise the Most High for showing me these things, these landmarks. And we're going to go see where our forefather Aaron was buried. We're going to go see where the actual Red Sea crossing is. We're going to dwell in the wilderness just like our forefathers did. Praise the Highest. The wilderness of Zin, yes. Kadesh. Rephidim. Yes, all these places. Yes, all these places you're going to see it. And I'm so happy. Shalom. Okay, we're in front of another tomb. And I just want to show you. There's some stairs that go right up to it. These are places that were built. They call them the Nevi'im, but we know that they are the Hebrew Israelites. It's the same inscriptions, the same structures that was built in Egypt. They are... When the children of Israel came out of Egypt, we came across the Jordan and we built these monuments and places. And when our forefathers died, these are the tombs that were built. So again, if people want proof of tombs and things of that nature, it is right here. They can't deny it and they can't explain it away. They have no proof that these are not the children of Israel. They try to call them the Nabataeans, just like they call them the Hyksos. But these people just seem to vanish off the face of the earth. And they there's no record of the Nabataeans or the Hyksos. Okay, here we go, our brothers selling scarves. Thank you. So we walking down the souk. It's a long way. You gotta walk. The face of Most High. Praise the Most High, children of Israel. We walking down the souk. Yes. Oh, we making it through. This is the souk. Yeah. We almost there. We have all kind of caves. And artifacts. This is a cave. In Petra. A small little cave. Hopefully we can see some ancient Hebrew writing. Of our forefathers. You can tell this is where they had water running. You can see. And the color of the rocks is amazing. No Hebrew Israelite has recorded us being here as of yet. And I praise the Most High and thank the folk Most High for being able to document this. The children of Israel coming through. This is the seek. It's called the seek. Ark is up ahead, videotaping, showing these children of Israel in the seek. All these pictures, just like Egypt, sculptures. It's carved in the wall, the same thing.
Yes.
Same thing in Egypt.
Yes.
This is what we built. Yep. Yeah. Yep, stone road. But, praise the higher. We have come and made record of it, the Hebrew Israelites. Have come, who know their Hebrews and know their Israel. We're not saying we the first black people that ever came here, but we the first recording this information when we know the truth, that we know that we are Hebrew Israelites, and we know that it was our forefathers who wandered in the wilderness with Moses, okay, and came across that Red Sea. It was our forefathers, and we know that, we know it. So now we can document it, and for those Egyptologists who need proof, who don't know that we were in Egypt and we came across that Red Sea and talking about there's no proof, come to Jordan, come to Petra, come to Kadesh. It's all the proof you need, because all these tombs are our forefathers. But of course you don't acknowledge the Bible and you don't want to accept that record, you will sit here and give claim to a people that's not even yours and don't want nothing to do with you. They don't want nothing to do with you. This brother was in Egypt.
Yes,
tell him. Tell him how they was acting.
Very cold blooded.
Hmm?
Very cold blooded.
And they don't want nothing to do with you.
Not at all, but get your money.
Right? Tell them. So you need to stop claiming heritage to a people that don't want nothing to do with you.
Nothing to do with you. They ain't got nothing. Egyptians don't want nothing to do with you.
Yes.
Other than get your money. That's
exactly.
All. Overcharge you. You for loud service.
Right. This brother was there.
I was there for about between a month, 2 months, and I had enough.
Yeah.
I have enough of them
kind of overcharged me for an apartment and lights and everything else. Not paying the light bill and wanted me to pay the previous light bill and all that kind of stuff. And then had the lights turned off because he wanted me to pay mine and the previous light bill that came at the end of the year. Mm-hmm. And the law in Egypt, if you don't pay the light bill up by the end of December, your lights get cut off. That's the president's rule from the president of Egypt. And they and this rental guy knew this. So he hadn't paid the old bill. And then going to add my little bill onto it, my 1 month bill. And then want to hold me ransom to pay another month's rent in order to keep the light turned light
okay. back. Okay, so you see, you so claiming you like claiming that. Heritage to a people that don't care nothing.
Don't care nothing about you.
And
they
I
don't care a rat behind about you.
Yeah, and I lived there for over a year and a half, almost 2 years. And I know that they don't care nothing about you. So you can claim heritage if you want to. But this is where your forefathers lay. And you need to come and check it out. Come and stop fighting with your brothers about it. And stop charging our money, our people money for a bunch of nonsense. And get out of Babylon. Shalom. We made it all the way to the treasury. This is where it said for Aaron's, for the Israelites, put the gold. What is this? Okay. Thank you.
Hello.
Thank you. Okay, thank you. Here we go. We at the treasury. This is where supposedly Pharaoh's gold is supposed to be hidden. And so I ask you, how did Pharaoh's gold get into Jordan? The children of Israel came with Moses across the Red Sea, and they came and journeyed for 40 years here. And they built these monuments and stored the gold of Pharaoh. And this is what you are not told. And the truth is coming out. Praise the Most High. So this is what it is. Now they shot the noses and the faces off all the monuments, if you can see up there. And it seems like they put a lot of different artifacts or whatever. But they took off a lot of the faces off of these things. So this is the treasury. We are at the treasury in Petra, Jordan, which is Kadesh. The children of Israel are here. These are the children of Israel who know who they are. Praise the Most High. And hold on. And you got these soldiers sitting here, guards. And the place is pretty crowded. There's a bunch of people. Little baby. Oh, baby. They got shops all around. I turned the camera around so you can see. It's the same structures that is in Egypt. The same structures that were made. They hide all these artifacts and tell you the Nabataeans built these things when it was actually the children of Israel built these monuments. Okay? And we're going to go to the other side. I'm sorry. And here's the same thing. These monuments and doorways. These are tombs where our forefathers are laid to rest. And they don't want to have no record of our forefathers being here. They call them the Nabataeans, but there's no history of Nabataeans or their offsprings. We are here. Praise the Most High. Praise the Most High. We made it. So we can show you. This place is amazing. And every Israelite should be out here now that we know the truth. And now that we know who our forefathers are. Now that we know who we are. Now that we know who we are, the children of Israel, come and see where your forefathers journeyed and sojourned for 40 years through this wilderness and built monuments and all kind of records of them being here. They don't want you to go in there. I'm sure there's inscriptions and all kind of writings in Hebrew for us to see. But they chopped off the faces off these monuments. But it's the same stuff we built in Egypt. Shalom. Okay, here we are. These are the tombs, the many tombs of Kadesh, where our forefathers dwell. Up those stairs are the high place of sacrifice, and that leads you all the way up, and you end up on the high place of sacrifice. These are the tombs, the carvings of our forefathers, the many tombs, the many carvings, just like in Egypt, you can see it is the same. And so you have to come and fill this place. And then after they took us down, then the Romans came in and they built these Colosseums, as you can see, the Roman Colosseums. But they have nothing to do with the tombs that were here. You know the story of how the children of Israel passed away here. They were not allowed to go into the Holy Land. And so there are many tombs here where the Most High, they were destroyed. So this is the record of the Israelites after they came out of Egypt, crossing the Red Sea. This is what Petra is all about. But because we went under the curse, we lost our identity. They chose to lie and hide this information from us. So, shalom out.
Killed all Amorites. You understand that, right?
Mm-hmm. Here's some more proof of the children of Israel being here, carving, making homes after being in the wilderness. All of these tombs and everything.
You gotta shave you too, that's the price.
What's up? Be careful, Derek. Camels, tombs, donkeys, little kids riding on donkeys. All these monuments, record of the children of Israel. Okay, y'all on a donkey? Christ rode a donkey. Christ rode on the donkey too. Yeshaya rode the donkey, yeah?
Hi, Jaden. Say hi to Instagram.
Hi. Hi. They on the donkey.
And see the baby right next to her mommy? See? Very good, guys. Okay. So we inside a Bedouin kind of store tent. And we stopped for lunch. So what you got, brother?
Oh, I got plenty of fruit. Juice. Flatbread, apples, tomatoes, cucumbers, juice, biscuit, known as biscuits, crackers. Oh, I'm doing great.
That's our little
small cheese,
little lunch,
cheese and
cheese.
Jelly to go with you. Nice lunch.
No meat. No meat.
Fresh vegetables.
Vegetables, fruit.
Yep. Plenty of that.
Praise the Most High. We give it honor and glory to Ahaya Bahashim Yeshaya for the food.
Yes.
Bless you. The water. Kahuwa wahalala Ahaya Bahashim Yeshaya, we thank you. Even though it's not what we used to, we bless you and thank you anyway.
We are great. This is wonderful.
Thank you, Ahaya. Thank you, Ahaya. We bless you, Ahaya. We glorify you, Ahaya. We praise you, Ahaya. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. There's no other name more powerful, more blessed than Ahaya. And we thank you. We glorify you. We praise your holy name. It's hot. It was just snowing three, four days ago. Mm-hmm. Snowing and cold. Now it's
put the snow on the ground.
Yeah. Now it's hot.
Nice,
like,
and beautiful.
Beautiful day.
Mm-hmm.
So we thank the Most High. We got a wonderful view.
Yes.
It's a nice place to just sit down and have some lunch. Yeah, thank you, Abba. We thank you, Abba. We glorify you, Ahaya.
The water, Abba.
The water, Abba. This column is one of the columns that were in Aqaba on the route commemorating the Red Sea crossing, and I'll show you the plaque.
Excuse me.
No, thank you. We okay. We okay.
You guys.
So it says, this is a column on the route to Egypt via Naqab al-Rabaya. The column is part of a ruined sanctuary. Okay, so why do they have this separated from all the other columns? Because there's a lot of columns, right? Now, there's a bunch of columns, and I'll show you later, but this one stands alone. And there's one just like it in Egypt that commemorates the Red Sea crossing. And this one stands alone from all the other columns. And they say it's on the route to Egypt. So we're going to praise the Most High. And where we are. Praise the Higher. Jaden, where'd you go? Where you go? Because she's going to follow you, Jaden. So come this way.
Even if lava, they get thrown into it, then what happened after?
Hij gaat er naar de voor.
Hoe trots hem in?
Wow, dat is pretty.
Cool. Hij gaat met de grote voor.
Hij grabs hem dus gewoon. Oh, Jesus, how
the devil the Hebrews.
I thought he's supposed to die.
The Hebrews.
Oh, so you mean
he don't want to burn by his soul?
Everybody's just chilling in their own world.
I just let all the angels apologize.
So, when we get in the wilderness, we'll be buying some goats and some sheep. Each goat is
so
about...
This, how much is the goat and the sheep? How much? One goat?
100.
100?
Yes.
Wow, that's awesome. So, each goat is about 100 JD? 100
JD? 100 JD?
Yeah.
Yes.
For one goat. So, when you buy...
You want a donkey the way back?
No. I'm just walking. I just want to talk about the goat and the sheep. 100 for goat? 100 JD?
100 JD?
Yeah, for yeah. Goat?
Yes.
And sheep?
Yes.
How much? Same? Huh?
What?
100 goat, 100 for the goat, 100 JD?
You're the sheep?
Sheep.
You're goat.
How much? The cam?
100?
Yes. Praise the Most High. So 100 for goat and 100 for sheep?
Sheep, 100.
100?
Yes.
Okay. So we come and buy some goat and sheep from you, yes? Okay, thank you. So now you hear it. The goat and the sheep you could get for 100 JD each. And we could start... going and building cattle and sheep. Praise the Most High. 100, yay. Let's go.
Okay. Kobe is back. There's gonna be Israelites back. You'll end this little orange brat and I'll give him a heart attack. Yeah, I'm back from round two. It's time to give another beating. And them other girls are wondering what the boys are needing. I overcame them and they upgraded to snooze. What makes them think them and their family can't stop me? They lost once to me. Their family lost to God. Face it, you're not even a hero of your own freaking story.
Up and coming rapper, come on now. Kwame Yashala, he gonna start doing some stuff about the Most High and his experience in the wilderness. Yeah, come on, you got one more?
Moses,
no, he don't got.
You got one more for us?
Moses, what? I don't know.
Encourage your brother. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, with me more. We want more. We want more.
Let's do it again,
more, more.
I see you on the camera.
Come on, come on over here. Come over here.
Can I do a regular rep? I
don't be scared. Know. Come over here. Boy.
Let me think.
Get over here, boy.
Okay. Okay. Begin?
Yeah.
Okay. You better stand back. I'm the king of the world, bub. While your entire family look like a Justin Bieber fan club. I'm the child of legend while you're just the child of shame. I'll beat you up so bad you'll think your mama is to blame. I'm the son of God, the holder of his legend. While you were playing conqueror's puppets by the devil. You think you and your face will serve your butt in short demise? I'm gonna put my big fist right between those beady eyes.
Oh, right. Yeah. Praise the Most High. He's gonna start using the Most High name, but give it up for Kobe! Yay! These are the goats and the sheep. And you see how many you can have, right? You can see how many you can have, right? They're about 100 JD each, and we can have a whole herd of them. Praise the Higher. Having their coffee, having their tea. They got the goats and the sheep. See all the goats? Yeah? Hi. Goats and the sheep, just relaxing. They're about 100 JD a piece. You can buy some goats and sheep. Yeah? Praise the Most High. Yeah. 100 JD for one. About, it depends on the Bedouin who you talk to. Whoa. But these are the goats and the sheep. Yeah. Let's get a close up of one. See? Hell of a. Yeah. Praise the higher. And the camel are coming. Watch yourself. Ah. The camel are coming this way. See all the camel? They're coming this way. Don't play with me. See how close they are? Camel. Praise the higher. We're gonna have all that. Camels and goats. And sheep. Hey. Praise the higher. Baruch Hashem Yishaya. We're going to have all this in the wilderness. Praise the Most High. Okay, let's go. Okay, here we are, guys. We made it to the cave. We got the fire going. We're going to do it Bedouin style. They working on dinner for us. Praise the Most High. Bless you. And thank you. Okay. They got the fire going. We didn't get to see how they start the fire. But they got the tea ready. You see? Yeah, making tea. With sage. And he's cutting up the vegetables. All outdoors. We could do it. The kids are playing. We got the Jeep. We made it. All the stuff. Okay. I see you guys. The kids are coming. Now we're inside the cave. Do I want to make some? Here we are inside the cave, Sister Sinai. You got internet?
No.
Oh, no. I lost my phone. I would have it if I had my, didn't lose my phone. But this is a nice little cave, right? It's cozy. Praise the Most High. We're going to be here all night. For two nights, actually. So this is home for two nights. We're in a cave. Got a little heat, a little light. And we're going to be cool, right? It's going to be okay. Praise the Most High. So this is where we're going to learn how to camp out and live in the wilderness. So I got to cut off because I don't have a lot of battery left. Shalom. The sister's riding on a donkey. We stood nine.
Derek, remember my story. Smack. I scared, Mom. I did it.
It's scary. Yeah, I'm sure. Children of Israel checking in. We making it. I'm okay, I don't need it. We're halfway there, guys. You see Mount Harun? We making it, people, we making it. Children of Israel in the wilderness. We checking in. It's been rough. But we making it. We started this morning. And, Jaden! Wait! We coming. Wait! Yeah, it'll save his shoes some.
Yeah, because your shoes is
Okay, we making it. It's been rough. You hear the system breaking down, babies crying, people. It's getting crazy, but we making it. We making it. Babies on camels. Come on.
Come here. Where you going? Wrong way.
See? We almost there, guys.
Yeah? Just sit there because your shoes mash up, man. You feel like you're going to fall?
We're making it, guys. It's rough. We're rough. But it ain't so easy. But Children of Israel, checking in. Shalom. Well, we made it up here. Praise Ahaya. Mount Hor. Be careful, Shaheen. Please.
It took us ages to get all the way up
here. Yes, it took us forever. But praise the Most High, we made it to Mount Haran, Mount Hor. The children of Israel are back. And look at this beautiful view. We in the wilderness. This is the wilderness where our forefathers sojourned for 40 years. Our forefather Aaron died on this mountain. And you know the scriptures. I'm going to post it. Praise. Please be careful with that baby.
Be careful with that baby.
No, no, no.
Hey. Why y'all bother with me? Don't worry, keep living. You're going to be 66.
She's playing. Hebrew playing games with us. Faze Ahaya, we are here. Yes, the brother made it. Come on, two more. They about to make it up this hill. They coming. Praise Ahaya. Children of Israel are here. Mount Hor. We're going inside the tomb to pray for our brother Aaron. Holy Land, Kadesh. We are in Kadesh. And as you know, Mount Hor is at the border of the children of Israel heritage. So we're still in within the borders, but this is one of the borders. Okay. So we're making it.
Say it again. I think that is it way back over there.
What?
That's your hotel. That is
Is that Dolly?
Well, that's definitely Dolly. That's
yes.
Where we are.
It's over there.
The red brick.
Wow.
Okay, it's to your west. To the west.
Okay, I just supposed to
tell them when they come up here, they really could see it.
When you come up a little higher, about 100 feet, you'll be able to see it better. You can see it real good.
That's the Bedouin village? Yeah. That's the Bedouin village right there.
Where?
Look, look at my hand.
Over there, right.
Yeah.
And then that's what's called there.
Yes.
That's Petra right there. Wadi, the Red Hotel.
Wadi Musa.
Site of Aaron, mm-hmm. Aaron's tomb, High Priest Aaron, named Moses, Moshe's brother, and it's just a wonderful blessing to be here, and all these wonderful Israelites, mm-hmm. children of Abraham, mm-hmm. and this is it. It doesn't get any better than this. This is the true gospel in its entirety, and you don't have to question it, wonder about it, go and dig it up, get it alive, mm-hmm. and this is it. So we're going to say a prayer.
So we're going to say a prayer. Y'all ready? Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Young Hebrew.
Yeah.
Very young Hebrew.
Yes. Praise the higher joint.
Yes.
Joining doing the prayers, Lord prayer. Awesome. So we're here to pay homage to our brother, our forefather Aaron. And all the children of Israel that went through the wilderness. It's a blessing to be here and see what they went through. Because the scriptures say they went up on a very high mountain, right? Yes. That mountain is very high. That mountain is woohoo! Yeah, that mountain, y'all see, this mountain is crazy. The children of Israel went up a very high mountain to bury our forefather Aaron, and that mountain is high. So it wasn't no joke, right, guys? How was that experience? How was that experience? How was the experience, guys, by climbing up that hill?
awesome.
The children of Israel had to go through that, right? And that is rough, right? It was something else, praise the Most High.
So they made it.
They made it, and so did we.
Yes.
We made it.
What's down there?
No, I don't know. I wanted to ask her, but I didn't want to go down there unless she told us it was okay.
Maybe it's really in heaven. That's like a line.
Y'all want to go down there? Yeah. I don't know. Ask your dad.
He's telling you guys have that time.
You don't have time.
You see the prophecies?
Flee her.
Yes.
Run.
Y'all can go down
get
there.
Get your suitcase, get your clothes, get the little money you got, and get your babies if you got children.
Yes.
Cousins and mamas and papas and everything else, and run.
Get out of here.
Get out
of
here.
Come out of here, my people.
Get out of here.
Hey.
We're trying to have the Passover.
Hey, come, you guys. She said down there is tombs, but you can't see. It's too dark. There's tombs down there.
But down there is what?
Yes.
Tombs.
Burial ground. Burial places. Okay, the pockets.
So we can't go down those stairs.
But anyway.
Why?
Mount Hor at the very top. Praise Ahaya. We made it. And look at this view. Praise the Most High. very high mountain where Mount Hor, where our forefather Aaron was buried. We made it up here. It took us a while. We're going to be in the desert for 3 days. This is our second day. Like the children of Israel, in Kadesh. And praise the highest. So amazing to be here, especially with other brothers and sisters who know the truth. The Most High is calling His people out, and they are here. And we are making it around in Kadesh. And it's not that hard, people. Don't be afraid. Obey the command of the Most High. Don't worry. He said He would take care of us. You understand? So y'all trust Him. All glory and praise to Ahayah Bahashim Yeshaya. Wakudash Wak.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. So y'all ready to make our way back?
No.
How soon?
With
I want to sing.
With the boy with the blue.
We're ready. Shabbat Shamaya.
With the blue one with the white. Here, Lady Kach. No good.
Kwadash Haya shall come a Haya. Malak with Ka. Zaba Vatasawanka. Hawa Isha. Maharataza Kawahaya Ooh Bashamayam Nathan Nawa Lakam Kayawam Wasalang Nawa Kawaf Nawa Kasalak Nawa Kawaf Nawa Wala Sabaya nawa, bina saya wama ba, hawashi nawa, mayari kayalaka. Amalakwa, wahala. Shalom. Tawaba wakwa, this is Sister Kana. We are out and about in the wilderness, and I'm making breakfast, eggs. We outside in the truck, and I just want to show you guys how we got to do it. We have to, do everything outside, guys, so I just wanted to show you. And you can look around and see the how we have to wash the dishes, yes, with the water.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And we're going to make some eggs, and we'll show you when we get everything done, okay? That we're going to make the eggs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, shalom.
Everyone, that's how we do.
Shalom. Okay, shalom. Now, these are the sheep, which you can see are much different because they're much hairier than the actual goat. But these are the sheep, and you can have a lot. Here go the babies. The babies. Yeah? Nice. You like that one?
Yeah,
he caught it. Yeah? Can I touch him? Yeah. Wait. Hold on. Yeah. Let me see. I'm on the video tell you. He caught him. He caught the sheep for me. So I could pet the sheep. Huh? Praise the Most High. These are the sheep and the goats. Well, there's no goats. It's really all sheep. But I think there's a goat right there. Yeah. Beautiful. So they're saying that we could get an even better price. They told me initially like 200 JD, 250, 300. Now it's down to like 100 JD. And you could buy some goats. Yeah. JD? Yeah. These are, you can touch? Yeah. These are the goats.
We want to thank you. Ahaya. Praise His holy name. Ahaya. Oh, praise His holy name. Ahaya. Praise His holy name. We give the glory.
That's it.
We want to thank you.
We wanna thank you. We wanna thank you. Ohio. Again. We wanna thank you. We wanna thank you. We wanna thank you. Ohio. Praise his holy name. Ohio. Pray. Oh, praise his holy name. Ohio. Praise his holy name. Ohio. We give the glory. We want to thank you. We want to thank you.